a cost protection scheme where the state is essentially committing to pay the legal fees of an applicant, a person who takes a judicial review case, or a group of people for that matter. There is a need to clarify standing rights. And what we're basically saying is that, you know, you need to be a legal personality to do that. You need, you know, certain criteria to be met in terms of environmental objectives, you know, duration of existence and membership.
Okay.
They're relatively low bar thresholds that in other member states or, sorry, other states, this is wider than European Union, you know, are more onerous. So it's essentially it's a check and balance on the fact that on the one hand the state is covering people's legal costs in accordance with Aarhus to ensure access to justice that is not prohibitively costly. On the one hand, you know, giving that right to people, but on the other, ensuring that it's not, you know, it can be used for the intended purpose.
Okay, but what I'm hearing you saying is that for a residents' association to be able to get into the judicial review and have that possibility of costs, that in order to do that, they have to meet all of those unincorporated criteria.
No.
All right, so...
we mentioned this earlier on, that we have clarified...
And apologies that
That's fine. We clarified that if you don't meet that company test, I'll call it, if you're a residents' association or another type of community group, you can take it as an individual's name or a group of individuals' names. There's nothing to prevent a group of individual, named individuals taking a judicial review. That has been clarified. So, and really...